All right, ladies and gents, it's been a bit since we have done the 10-time shared Civ bonus mod, but that's precisely what we have here. The way this works is we've got 8 players. I'll zoom in on them, don't worry. They're all playing Forest Nothing, so they have the chop through the trees. But every Civ bonus or starting bonus or whatever is multiplied by 10. And then it is shared with everybody that is currently in the game. And if you look here, you can notice they've get started with a lot of villagers here. That is probably because Mayans normally start with 1 more villager. So that was multiplied by 10. You get 10 more villagers and they started off at 13. So we're going to talk a lot about what techs are possible and what bonuses are possible. But can we first start off and complain to whoever created this mod? Why was there not 10 llamas? The bonus is... Oh, wait! It's 1 llama with 1,000 food! Oh, what a compromise! It's a super chunky llama! Yeah, because you normally start with 1 llama as the Incas. I just assumed it would be 10 separate llamas. Wow. Okay, so great balancing from whoever created this. In the gray, we have, playing as the Incas, Tea Time. All right. And that Tea Time is why the llama is there. Oh, wait. Does that mean Inca houses that normally have +5 pop space are going to have +50 pop space? That's honestly incredible. Let's try not to get caught up on bonuses just yet. Let me do in the introduction. In the orange, playing as the Mongols is Ramarinic. In the teal, very close to the edge of the map. Also, the player who asked me what is a good build order for this map is No Trick Pony, playing as the Koreans. In the yellow, we have Scorpios playing as the Tatars. Wait a second! And that means he gets extra food on his sheep, right? Oh my god, how did someone just make it to feudal age? Okay, playing as the Tatars. In the blue, we have Isla Baskets playing as the Poles. In the green, we have Reckless Sarge playing as the Mayans. In the did I say green or red? In the red, sorry, we have Reckless Sarge playing as Mayans. In the green, we have St. Arnulf of Metz playing as the Khmer. And then last but not least, we have Stanislav playing as the Brit. Wow, there's actually another bonus at play. The fact that you eat your sheep faster with the Britons is at play for everyone here. So there's a lot of food income, which might actually explain why they were able to move up to feudal age so quickly. Unfortunately, they do have trees inside of their town centers at times. They really need a wood bonus here. But Tatar's sheep have lots of food. They got extra food on that sheep because of the Inca start. And then you have the Britons at play here as well. And the Mayans' longing resort. Wait a second. Wait a second, guys. The Mayans' laster longing resources. That applies to the trees as well. Oh no! What have we done? Oh, I was gonna comment on how it applied to the sheep. But it now applies to the trees. No! What have we done? Thank God we put it on fast speed. Originally it said we were going to do it on normal speed. Whoa. What has Baskets done? Wood, please. Oh, interesting. Baskets deleted his town center so he could make a lumber camp and get his wood upgrade. I mean, this is not very efficient. We'll see how this pans out for him. The problem is, this version of Forest Nothing also starts with so many trees that it's all up in your TC. So you could see, it doesn't look like you could fit a TC there for a while. So he's not going to have a TC for a long time. Might actually end up being good for him in the long run, we'll see. But oh boy. Okay, but I need to explain certain aspects of this, okay? So we had done this before, and we had an issue where certain texts wouldn't be shared because people were fighting each other. Because it's a shared Civ bonus mod, which means you're only getting to share that with an ally. So what I did was I said, let's go to 45 minutes where everyone's allied. Yes. Then everyone has the enemy. And the goal is by then, everyone will have researched their unique texts. So for example, like the Tatars can research their Treb range, and then that should apply to everyone. In the event that they're enemies before they can get their unique techs, then those texts are not going to be shared. So I'm a little concerned on the timeline I set now, because these trees are going to last forever. So, I mean, we're going to be here for a while. And thank you everyone for watching. Hope you guys are interested. I'm also going to tell a story I've never told my community before, and it just dawned on me earlier in the day during this. So it's probably the perfect game for a story, because it's kind of long. Kind of stupid as well, but kind of long. Gray says, and this is maybe what Baskets was going to try and do. He said, don't delete your TC and try and make a market. Won't work. Also, can't rebuild your TC. True. And I guess Baskets, he's trying to make a full work. But, okay, he's just going to make a new lumber camp. Is it not more interesting as Diplo when you have to think about whether to trade your unique text with the other players? The problem is when you start to, like, turn it on and off again, I think it stops what can be shared. And I have an issue with Diplomacy King of the Hill, because it stops the triggers on the monument from working properly. So instead of the countdown going up to 100, it goes up to 50. And it's also got some weird shared things, whether you're allied with someone or not. We had a game spoiled by that in the past. Reckless Sarge says, time to tell a story. There was once a man, a great man called T90. He would stream for all to join. Dude, you didn't even spell the word right, Reckless Sarge. He said, enjoy. Well, I messed up my story. I'm done. Okay. All right. Seriously, though, they've made, like, no progress. This is bad. This is super bad. Like, I haven't even seen a tree get chopped through yet. Randoming into Mayans was the worst thing that could have happened. If only we had Celts to counteract that with the faster wood chopping.
Yes.
What's the Mayan percent usually? I think it's 10% faster resources? Or 10% longer lasting resources? I mean, I am the guy who's covered multiple longest games of AoE 2 ever. I like to go past my limits. The fact that this has happened is content and could lead to some interesting scenarios. It's 15%? I thought it was 10. It's 15? Dang. We're not restarting this, and I'm going to tell you why, okay? Eventually, they're going to chop through enough trees where they can build a market. And with that much wood and with that much food that they brought in, how do they have that much food? What? How do they have that much food? Is that all the llama? Is that the 1,000 food? 15% times 10? Someone do the math. Maybe it is. The super llama. Anyways, they just need to sell off some resources to be able to go castle and go fast imp. And then they could research Onager to cut through the trees. So the laster longing resources will only be an issue if they don't get to Onager. So, oh god, they're going to go in a circle with stories now? Anyways, the ultimate goal is to control the monument. So that llama ends up being 4,000 food. All right, so but hold on. Before we really get down to business, yes, Baskets, let's go! Okay, watch this. Baskets knows what's up here, man. Also, you can build the market on top of the Holy Llama. Dang. Okay, hold on. Market events. Selling wood. Selling more wood. Don't sell all your wood. I've sold all my wood here before, and I didn't have enough wood for a lumber camp, and I lost. Okay. Because I deleted my market before I realized. Okay, so now he can build his TC. Oh, this is going to be so funny. This is going to be... Oh, wait. No, it's not. Never mind. I was thinking he still has to make another building, but because there's Khmer, he doesn't actually need the blacksmith too. Good. So now he's going to Castle Age, and he actually has the resources to go Imp as well. So this is fine. So he can go from Castle Age immediately to Imp, immediately into a Siege Workshop, immediately into Onager, and then he can start chopping the wood. Okay. Sheesh. But, okay, this is what I wanted to say to you guys. Do I reach out to them and say, we need to extend the time? because I expected them to make so much more progress by 20 minutes. I think I should be messaging somebody. I wonder who my best bet is. I guess Baskets, because he's kind of ahead. One second. We need to make sure this happens. I'll message the host as well. Please, instead of 45 minutes, agree to not attack until everyone researched their unique techs in Castle. Thanks. I'm going to send this off to two people and hopefully they get the message. And I'm going to post it in the chat as well where we set things up. And we're just going to continue on here with the content and bam. Okay. All right. So good time for me to tell my story then, right? Let's just dive into it because this is actually going to get a lot faster. So first off, this isn't, I don't know if there's a tier list of T90 stories out there. It's not going to be high up on the tier list, but it is a story that's worth telling. I've never told you guys before. So what better time? Okay. So it's worth reminding many of you or mentioning to start off this story that I grew up in quite a sheltered environment. I went to a private school from seventh grade onwards. It was a private religious school. Okay. And it was so small that my grade, when I ended up graduating high school, it was the biggest grade in the entire school. It was a K through 12 school, graduating class of 32 people. The biggest class had a graduating class of 32 people. So I don't know your situation. Maybe that's not small for you, but compared to people who went to different schools where I grew up, that's incredibly small. You're just in the same room with like pretty much everyone else, right? Also, Baskets deleted his TC again, and he is going... Interesting. What's he doing? He's going for a full work now. Meanwhile, these guys are telling a story. I'm telling my own story. So I went to a very small school is the point. All right. Sixth or seventh grade. Forget which grade it was, actually. But middle school, we had an interesting situation where we had our language class. So we had like Spanish. That was also when our school started to do sexual education, right? At a Christian school, it was very uninformative and very awkward. So we're not going to get to that part of the story. But what that meant was, instead of having Spanish class be co-ed or Spanish class with the boys and the boys would do the Spanish class while the girls would do their like sex ed class. And then the boys would do their Spanish class. So we'd be doing Spanish class with all the guys is basically what I'm getting at, okay? And our Spanish teacher... Not good. Not very good at holding down the peace. We're a bunch of rowdy boys. And it was like near the end of the day. And we weren't punished properly, probably. And so we would just do crazy stuff. Yes. It was just a crazy, ridiculous situation. And I feel bad looking back for the teacher. But anyways. So at one point. Hold on. Did they figure this out now? Should we ask T90 to extend the time? They're saying yes. They're typing what I've typed. Okay, that's perfect. Okay, we continue. So, I do not know why this dawned on us, but the one day, we were going to have like a Spanish fiesta, Spanish party in Spanish class, okay? And let me go over here to workers. About big disparity in the worker count. And so leading up towards that, at a study hall near the end of the year, we all had leftover paper that we weren't using anymore. And so we decided to make paper balls, right? So like, think of it. It's like the last month of school. You got a bunch of stuff you're not going to need anymore. You're bored in the study hall. So we started smushing up these paper balls. And our wild idea was we're going to start throwing them at each other during Spanish class. Pretty harmless stuff, right? By the way, Gray's about to hit him. Congratulations to him. A lot of other people are still in feudal. So, when I say that we made paper balls, like, we really made paper balls, There was about 20 of us in that class, I think. And we each had our backpacks stuffed with paper balls. Some of them even had drawstring bags stuffed with paper balls. We had a lot of paper balls. And so we get in there, and we've got our backpacks next to our desk, and we're getting ready. It was going to be this big surprise thing. One of our friends was going to, like, do something to cue us, and then we all, like, rah! Start chucking paper balls. Our teacher would probably be really upset, right? So, we're in there, waiting, all excited, again, 6th or 7th grade, and all of a sudden, the door just flies open, okay? And our principal at the time is the middle school principal. Where are the paper balls? Freaking out. Like, he's, like, red in the face. He's really upset. Like, you'd think it was horrible what we had done. We just had paper balls. And so, long story short, dude got really upset. And it's like, who has paper balls? And we're all like, we all have paper balls. And it's like, this is unacceptable. This is unfair. Ruining the party, you know, that this teacher's put up, whatever. He wasn't happy about it. Complete overreaction on his part, in my opinion. It was just paper balls. But he's very upset. And he took it very seriously. It was like, went around with three different papers. It was like, sign this one if you made a paper ball. Sign this one if you knew about it but didn't say anything. And I don't know what the third one was, but I definitely remember it was like us putting our names onto lists, which then led to everyone who knew or made a paper ball having an in-school suspension for a day. ISS for paper balls. Now, again, it could have been an accumulation of events because we were horrible in that class throughout the whole year. So I could maybe understand it from that perspective. But every guy except for two individuals got ISS all at once for this. And normally, like, parents would probably be pretty upset about that. Like, you know, what are you doing? By the way, Onager's being researched by Baskets. The parents didn't really care because they thought it was ridiculous. Okay? So, that happened. It was super weird. And then time passed. And then fast forward to when it's senior year of high school. Who was formerly the middle school principal was then the high school principal. So he was our principal, and we were going to graduate high school. So naturally, what we did was we conspired with an employee or two, and also a principal's wife. We somehow got her in on it. Oh my God, dude, you need an onager, you idiot. Baskets. And we filled his entire office and his entire car full of paper balls. We had to get all these people in on it, obviously. We didn't break in, okay? We're good Christian kids. Filled his office with paper balls, like, up to chest height, and then also his vehicle. And then he found it. He thought it was funny. And he actually took us all out for lunch and apologized for his conduct 5 years earlier or whatever, and wished us the best. That's the story. Not my craziest story ever, but I can't believe I never told you guys that story before. And it got brought up earlier. Well done, Baskets, by the way. Well done. He has fast-tracked this game. He's on Onager now, and he could free up and get some space. Somehow getting past... And Gray as well! Let's go! Somehow getting past the situation here. Meanwhile, some of these other players are just playing this like a standard game. Still on the llama, and just producing a bunch of villagers. But yeah, how cool was that of him, though, to not get angry about it and to be like, you know what? I overreacted back in the day, and that's cool, and I wish you guys the best. I really respect the guy for that. We got Onager over here as well. And I was pretty proud of that prank. You know, as far as pranks are concerned, I thought that was pretty wholesome, so. Okay, Green says, I don't have enough wood for a building because I sold too much. No! This is the mistake I mentioned earlier. Oh my God! He is 93 wood. He can't afford a lumber camp. He can't afford a town center or a market. Can they send him resources? Someone needs to send him resources, but no one has the room. Okay, maybe Red can send him. Red, send him some resources here, please. Oh, actually, he could? There is a way. Oh, man, it's so tricky. He says, please, guys, do it for the community. Now, he's basically like, do it so people don't talk about me in the comments. So if you build a farm, you will drop off the resources that you your villagers have. But I don't know if it drops it off with everyone. Ay, 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 ay. So Green's basically just going to sit here waiting and hoping to receive some resources. Because that farm is 60 wood, right? So you're never going to get enough to go over 100. I don't actually know if they all drop off, because I've only ever done that with individual villagers. Oh, wait, he must have received resources, surely, right? Ah, TC is free. TCs are free! The town centers are free because Britons have cheaper town centers. How did we forget? Because Britons have a discount on town centers, guys. He could have just made the TC for free anyways. Saved. Saved. Okay. All right. That was funny. Man, this... I tell you, this mode creeps up on you because you forget about stuff. By the way, now Baskets is adding more vills now that he has space, which seems really smart. You have a similar thing happening here for Teal. In terms of food income, guys, because there's poles here, they're going to have insane food spikes when they make farms around a fulwark. In fact, if you get... I think we did this before. If you get 10% of your farm's food as a spike when you finish a farm around a fulwark, don't you immediately finish the farm? I'm pretty sure you do. So the farms are just going to bring in all the food instantly. Interesting stuff. Okay, so let's talk about military bonuses a little bit here, because I need to think about what could stack. So we're going to start with the poles. Knights costing less gold. Knights are going to be free. Or not free, but they're just not going to cost any gold at all. Winged hussars getting trample damage won't have an effect on anyone else because... Actually, no, it would, right? Because it's not just winged hussars. I think it's just the light cav line. So anyone who could make hussar would have that. The Mayans are not going to be super helpful here. But you do have the skirmisher tech, which would give a lot of extra little bolts, which could be fun. El Dorado would apply to the Incas, actually, which could be helpful for tea time because it just applies to eagles. In the green... Okay, you have a double crossbow, which adds extra bolts to the scorpions, which is going to be nice. Scorpions are always good in this. You also have tusk swords, which gives extra attack on your elephant. So instead of +3, I think it is, it's +30. That would obviously only help him and no one else. So that's actually not very helpful. Ooh, something we should go back with Mayans, though. Is Mayans have cheaper archers, so it's probably, I mean, very easy to make them. And then they will have Britain range. Sarge. What do you... Okay, Sarge is having fun. Yeah, so Britain range could be important. Okay, Britons, we just talked about the range, which will help everyone's archers. That already applies, but then you have Yeoman, which is going to give... an additional +1 range to the archers, which would be a +10, obviously. Then you also have Warwolf, which is increased accuracy on trebs. That's not going to, like, multiply. But then the splash damage on the trebs, combined with the Tatars, which we'll get to, which give you +2 range on a treb. Bro, I want to see some trebs. The only thing we're missing is Japanese. Okay. Incas have fabric shields, which adds armor to their eagles. So actually, Eagle Warriors could be really insane in general, right? El Dorado plus Fabric Shields. Eagles might... Dang, that's going to be crazy. And then the other unique tech is one of the most useless unique techs in the game, Andean Sling, which gives minimum range to skirms and slingers. I guess, again, there's Mayan Skirms bonus, which could be cool, but who cares? Mongols. Faster Siege. That's going to be fun, because it's 50% faster siege times 10. And then Nomads is also kind of useless. But I mean, Siege in general could be good. By the way, Teal started the countdown. There we go. 550-year countdown. Yeah, everyone's got to pick it up here. Oh my god, they got sheep from the Tatars. Oh, you get more sheep from new town centers with the Tatars. Baskets just deletes his TCs because he's sick of all the space being used up. What in the world? Okay, I don't know what's happening here. This is very hard to explain. I just got massive deja vu. Yes. You won't really need to make a farm because of the sheep, but the farms are actually more efficient. I don't know how to make sense of all this. Okay, sorry guys. Let me continue around. Yellow, we have Tatars. We already talked about the sheep, obviously. You have... Whoa! Look how fast the Onager moves! Look how fast it moved right there. Woo! Sorry, I'm losing my train of thought. You have the Treb Tech, which gives +2 range on the Trebs, but also gives you access to Flaming Camel. And then you have Silk Armor, which adds additional armor to Cav, specifically the Hussar line. So actually, Polish Hussar bonuses combined with the Tatar Hussar bonuses, that's not bad. And then, yeah, is that it? I think that's it. There will obviously be things that we realize are strong and not so strong, but... I think Baskets is looking to kill because we originally said 45 minutes. I want everyone to get their unique text ASAP. Because, again, once they enemy each other, then this all becomes problematic. I don't think you can go back. And someone had just asked... is there... Sorry, the Sonager is so distracting. When they enemy each other, do you lose the bonuses? No. So when you receive the bonuses, you keep them forever. Which is why I want them to all receive as many bonuses as possible and then all be enemies. You know what's so jarring for me? Is to see how fast the Onagers move around and then how slow the shot is in comparison. I mean, the shot's not even that slow, but... There's a big difference between that and the speed. Okay. Oh, also, Koreans. We missed Koreans, guys. Where's Koreans? Koreans. No trick pony. Also, what the crap is that? This is a packed... Okay, those are packed town centers. That's the thing. Don't Koreans have a tech that gives their Onagers extra range? 8+10 range right now. If Koreans get that technology, then Onagers would be really strong. Yeah, Korean towers could be strong too. Oh man, okay. Nomads breaks the Inca house bonus apparently. Oh, does it? Okay. I can't really see pop space with this, unfortunately. But you know, like, I thought this was going to be way worse than it actually has turned into. So I've had fun thus far. I'm sure for some of the players, their struggles have... Dude, Baskets, you're being such a nerd. Get out of here. I'm sure for some of these players, their struggles have made them not enjoy this so much, but it's been an interesting build-up. Oh my god. Okay, so Baskets is 8+11 range on the siege. He's making his way towards the monument. He's also going to be making keeps now. I'm curious to see the stats on these things. 8+20 range. All right. Countdown's still at 450 years. We still have plenty of time. There's only one civilization in here that actually... No, two civilizations that get Siege Onager. That would be Mongols and Koreans. They're actually right next to each other. I think this is something that has to do with Force Nothing. I don't think it's a 10x shared Civ bonuses mod, but those are town centers that are packed up. But what happened with the Goths, +10 pop and Impere? I think they'd get +100, and also their infantry would basically be free because of the discount. And if you were to combine that with, like, Vikings HP and Burmese attack and Japanese attack speed and Malian Pierce armor could be decent. I still think a big issue for Goths would be... oh, and then Celts for the speed as well. But I still think a big issue for Goths or infantry in general is the lack of HP. Because it's a melee unit and there's no upgrade with infantry to give them more HP like you can do with other things. But I think Goths could be pretty insane. I think one of these days, what we could do is we could stack it. Like, we've been doing random civilization, but eventually we should stack it. So we say, okay, guys, everyone go for infantry choices and then play. But yeah, I don't think that's something we need to do right now. Oh, wait, stone buildings are cheaper with the Inca bonus, which means the castles might be free and the towers might be free. What's the discount again? Is it 15%? I always forget. I know that their stone buildings are discounted. Hmm. Has everyone done their researches? Yes. Question mark. No, yes. Okay, Stanislav needs to get a castle up ASAP here. I mean, he says castle's expensive. Oh, that's true. He is at the limit. He'd need stone. Someone could send it to him. Who else doesn't have it? Red? No, Red has tons of castles. Wait, why is a castle expensive, bro? A castle's not expensive. He just doesn't realize. It should be super cheap. Should be free. He just hasn't realized, which is kind of funny because Green didn't realize his town center was free earlier. I think he might be underestimating the Mayan skirm bonus plus range bonus from Britons. Maybe, but a lot of my experience, this stuff does come back to HP, and skirmishers are still a 35 HP unit. But I want to see it for sure. Stanislav, castles are free, man. Make a castle, get your text. You're one of the most important ones. No, don't turn. Yellow's saying, Baskets, you just want to kill me. He says, sling me some gold. And there's the castle now. Okay. I mean, Warwolf and Diamond's pretty expensive. I'm surprised he doesn't have more gold. I think he's been buying stone. You could tell... Guys, look how many players bought stone and then realized they didn't need it. Everyone! Also, how does No Trick Pony have stone income? What is he doing? Oh, he has the monument. Ah. Oh god, this is so cramped. Okay, let's see. Is he gonna get his text now? Okay. Lots of castles. Only need 900 gold. Okay. I'd be doing the same here. Just dropping as many buildings as possible. I hope my computer can take it. When this eventually goes crazy. Basket, stop camping, Scorpios, man. Okay, he's making a treb. All right. I think the way Sarge has built up just a line of castles is not good. I think he's going to need more space than that. I think he's going to die insanely fast. No, Baskets isn't going to attack grounds because we have rules here. Oh, guys, okay, you gotta send this guy resources here, please. He's realizing castles are free. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. And hey, everyone, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed my story about the paper balls. We coined that the paper ball incident. I know it was a little bit random. I'm really impressed with how many players got themselves out of this starting position. Yeoman's on the way. Okay, and then he needs Warwolf. I want to watch. Does that apply to plumed archers? Stanislav says I need one more tech. Okay. Paper money, paper balls. You know, you guys were expecting one of those two things to be discussed today. Okay, it's almost in. Yellow still hasn't researched unique text. I thought yellow did. Maybe not. Okay, Yeoman's in. The plume's now 14 plus 32. Ah, siege might not be good here. Siege might not be good at all. I mean, obviously you could still land shots, but these also have 200 HP. Hmm. All right, these guys are attack grounding here. Want to trade anyone? Scorpios, dude. Are there any Trebs so I can check range? They're getting antsy. Treb. No, he doesn't have it yet. Oh, we tried so much. He's got to communicate. That's the problem. He has to say, I don't have my unique text yet. What's his resources look like? Oh, he's never going to get it. I mean, Baskets is saying, like, can you research? The problem is if your units cost gold. So I think they're going to say, Purple's going to say, I have both techs now. But Yellow hasn't said anything, and they're all going to start fighting. But, okay, the Tatar techs not being in is a little sad, but I don't think Trebs would have done much anyways. So Yellow could have saved himself by saying something, but is a little distracted. Now everyone needs to turn to enemy was kind of the plan. This is going to get insane. I can't wait to see these skirmishers fire. They're all saying 14, start the game already. Enemy each other. It's all going to get started. And there we go. It all begins. Apologies for all the pop-ups on screen. This is going to get insane. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ah! Okay. Well, those towers are freaking insane, bro. Oh, look at the plumes. The plumes are getting melted. Is that by the towers? I think that's by the turrets, dude. I think the towers are stronger than the... Maybe stronger than anything I've seen so far. Holy crap. Scorpios is still allied with people, by the way. He's living his own dream. I wonder if him researching the text now would apply to them because he's allied to them. I don't know. Oh, God. Well, Siege Onager Tower seems to be good so far. Baskets is just going to drop more towers because he's like, that seems to be the winning play. Whoa. It looks so cool when the towers are all firing from the same position. Huh. Well, you know, Gray's taking his good old time back here. Green is as well. And Green's making scorpions with Khmer. We haven't seen scorpions yet in this game. Remember how bonkers scorpions were when we had Celts? I forget if we had Celts and Khmer in the same game, though, because that would probably be the ideal stack. That or Ethiopians. Dang, man. And remember when we said that Sarge was just building up towards one unit and that would be a problem? Well, that becomes a problem. As good as I think the Eagles could actually be here, I'm not sure anything can really compete with how many shots are coming out of these towers. Holy crap. And the towers are free as well, right? But these Kamioks don't stand a chance. 222 years, by the way. We still haven't seen a lot from Orange. It's a bit of a shame that the Tatar player didn't research the Hussar tech. Because that would give these a lot more pierce armor. But still, I'm not sure 320 HP is enough. Whew! They just got a tower war the other player. The Korean ones do have more attack for some reason. I think Baskets is missing blacksmith techs, honestly. And Sarge says, there goes my entire empire, GG. Well, you still have the forever sheep. And watch, you get more sheep when you finish this TC. You're good. Ready? Bam. You can last forever on this. I kind of like the plan from Baskets. He just figures, if I just keep towering, I can eventually out-tower him. drill Seadrams. I mean, Seadrams should be good, but against these towers, I'm not so sure. Let's see if yellow eventually gets that tech. Oh my god! This is what I mean, guys! Uh-oh. Bonk. Got a micro. Bam. There's Elite Longbow. Elite Longbow could be really good. Again, they lack HP, but if they have more range than the towers and the castles, that could be effective. Oh god, it's a tower war. It very frequently comes back to towers. Oh, here's Seadram. Let's see how fast the Seadrams take out the towers. Oh, that's epic! And Koreans don't get Seadram, which really hurts. Oh, Seadram was so much better than I expected. I thought because they, you know, lack the HP, it would be a problem. In a normal game, it'd be really good. Oh, Seadrams are huge. Yeah, and then Baskets is going to have towers, and then someone else is going to need Seadram against this. Zoom. I love to see the random rams go through. All right. More towers being built. More towers being destroyed. Oh! Longbows against scorpions. You got quick maths here. 47 range on the longbows. It's so funny, though. They fire so high. It's extremely inefficient how they fire. Look at that. If they fired straight, it would be so much better. It wouldn't look as cool, though. And green's starting to get destroyed here by Stanislav. Zoom! Hussars? How do they fare? What hussars? Do you guys remember when there were hussars? I don't. How about Kamayuks? It looks like the unique tech from the Incas is kind of paying off a little bit. They're actually not doing too bad, not compared to the hussars. Still can't take out the towers. I think everyone needs to be building their own towers right now, with towers being free. And gray is the middle, so I mean, that's a positive. Meanwhile, the longbows are going to town. Again, they're firing straight up in it. Look, look at all these shots. That's a lot of longbows, though. I'm excited to see purple come towards the middle. The problem with Britons will be that you can't hold the middle with the longbows. You could just help contest the middle. Baskets is the highest rated player in this lobby, by the way. Yikes. How much army does Baskets have? Three. Three military, and yet is about to have the highest kill count. But Gray will have Seadrams as well. Honestly, all of Baskets' hard work is going to be done. Or undone here. Oh, also, the villagers are extremely strong because they get the blacksmith technologies from the infantry upgrades, which I forgot about. That's an Inca bonus. And we're even seeing skirmishers getting tossed into the Seadrams. I think green will eventually die to this, but let's see. We have super skirms. Whoa, look how many shots they fire! What? Look at that! What? Dude. They still get flattened by anything that hits them, but they are... That's insane. I swear we saw Mayan skirmishers before and it wasn't this ridiculous. It must be a combination with other things too. Yeah, get away, longbows. Plus the scorpions too. Oh, geez. This could be a problem. Oh. My god! They need more rams! They need more rams! And you need Seadram. But props to Green for fighting back so nicely here. I was expecting Green to get rolled. Green doesn't have blacksmith upgrades! Green! You are 3 plus 1! It could be 3 plus 4! Oh god! That's so painful. Alright, well, you know, lesson learned. We got 87 years. The thing is, Baskets doesn't actually have units really holding the middle. So if they could get into the middle, maybe this could do something. Oh, man. I don't know. Sarge? Eagles, maybe? You got something? He's getting capped ram for us. Okay. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I mean, I don't think they can get to the middle with anything. There's just so many towers. More towers than we've ever seen in this game mode, by the way. And this is still with a stack that doesn't have every tower bonus. Like, if you had Celts, unique tech, strongholds, combined with Japanese, I mean, there's just so many different things that we could talk about with towers. Inca's obviously very helpful. You need all rams to have any chance. And with 63 years, it might be too late. Well, this has been an interesting one. Look at the light cav meat shield there. Green and purple are talking about maybe clearing the middle to get here. Oh, choo-choo! The problem is siege isn't discounted, right? Oh, God. Holy. Yeah, siege isn't discounted at all. So it's actually quite expensive, and towers are not expensive. So no one has gold to be able to make 200 rams. If they had slavs and siege was discounted, then it would be fine. But like, oh, here we go, orange. Let's go. Ultimate tower defense here for baskets. Okay, making progress. He might actually be able to reset the countdown. I'm not kidding. I'm kidding. Okay, never mind. Oh my god. I know it, we like kind of know what to expect to an extent, but this crap is still ridiculous, man. Like, what? I wish I could somehow track how many projectiles were thrown in this game. Again, if they could get a unit there and reset it, maybe they've got a chance. Red says I just sarged myself. I'm not sure exactly what that means. He does say you just got sarged if you kill someone in the community game. So that might mean he killed himself. Whoa! Whoa! Hold the phone! Guys! Are these rocks not bigger than you remember? Excuse me? They're not normally that big. What was researched to make those projectiles so freaking big? These guys are throwing bowling balls over here. They're still going to do very little damage. But they're chucking bowling balls. What made that happen? Wow, okay. Well, unfortunately for us, we can't watch this unfold even longer because I think this is going to be over. Green's going to try and get through. Honestly, if Orange needs to go to the middle with the rams. But I think there's a unit there. Yeah. And it's like near impossible for them to try this right now. There's just bodies everywhere. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Cannonballs from the slingers. Oh, and they're all dead. Picked the wrong bowling club. Or the wrong knight for your bowling club. There we go. Teal's going through. Pathing issues. Oh, so close. Woo. GG. Most created unit for the winning player. 33 rams for baskets. The greatest mistake for No Trick Pony was to show baskets the potential of the towers. What a funny game. Okay, so how many towers was it? 223 towers, 1,300 kills. Whew. That was way faster than I expected. When I saw Mayans in this, I thought it was going to be a complete disaster. You know what would have made it a disaster? Was if we didn't have Incas. Right? Because without Incas, we don't start with the Llama. And, like, we could have maybe lived without Tatars. I think Tatars helped as well. But, God, if they didn't start with the Llama and it was Mayans, I don't see an easy way they get past or under, like, 2.5 hours. Man. Yeah, castles are free and towers are so much better than them. Yeah, that was great. Thank you, everyone, for putting yourselves through this. Yet again, it was very complicated. I've enjoyed doing this with Random Civ because we kind of get different flavor every time. For example, we would have never seen Incas and seen that Slingers, for some reason, throw cannonballs. I still don't understand why that is. Maybe someone will have a reasoning for it. I'm not sure if they really did more damage, but maybe. Okay, here's a thought. Maybe the way the game works is the more damage that the slingers do, the bigger the balls get. So are there other techs we can stack with Incas so these guys throw even bigger balls? You didn't think I'd be talking about this many balls in this game as I did. But anyways, hope you enjoyed. This was super cool. Baskets says, thanks for hosting. That was very stressful. No, well played, Baskets. Well played, everybody. I'm getting to a point with this where I think it would be really fun the next time we do it to try and make the most OP composition of one particular thing possible. So by that I mean we do an infantry one. Now, that might not mean infantry is actually that strong. I think towers are still going to be strong, especially because a lot of tower civilizations have good infantry. But like if we did Goths, Japanese, Burmese, Malians, Vikings, just trying to think of more infantry civs, Teutons for melee armor. I think doing a 8 infantry civs and just seeing if the infantry's even good, just to see how it goes, how it works, that could be fun. And then we could do the same with everything. Also, what we did do, which we could do more of in the future with this, is we could just do a 4v4 game, which I will cast, and each team gets to decide what they want to do. The last time we did that, that was pretty cool. It wasn't very competitive, because the one team went for elephants and eco, but it was still pretty fun. Anyways, I hope people enjoyed. Let me know your ideas in the comments later on YouTube. Let's look at the stats here. Not a bad KD either for Baskets. And basically for anyone who made a lot of towers or longbows, it was good fun. We'll definitely do more of this in the future. Maybe like once a month or something. I don't want to get too tired of it too fast, but just super cool this stuff works, man. Like, honestly, the fact that the game doesn't disconnect way more frequently when we do these types of things is insane to me. I used to have so little faith that these types of things would run, so credit to the devs who don't even officially support these mods, but just for making a game that works with this stuff. It's the beauty of Age of Empires 2. Also to the map makers and mod makers and fixers and all those things too, because I know patches can sometimes need or mean that these certain things need upgraded. So, or updated. Sorry, horrible outro, but yeah. Glad you watched, liked the video, blah, blah, blah. GG.